President, please be seated.
Le Président, veuillez prendre vos places.
The court is now in session.
L'audience est reprise.
Yesterday, before the adjournment,
l'audience est donc ouverte. Hier, avant
it was a time for the prosecution to respond
d'audience plutôt.
To the
le
defense team's objections.
L'accusation qui avait la parole pour
half an hour was taken
aux objections
by the national prosecutor
la défense,
and another 30 minutes.
Procureur cambodgien attendait pendant une demi-heure. Il reste donc une demi-heure pour le procureur international.
So we will continue with that time allocation, and for that reason, I'd like to inquire with the prosecution
de la part des procureurs.
In regards to the questioning time for the true witnesses,
combien de
that
temps
is TCW 766 and 542 for early next week. How much time does the prosecution need
502.
To question these two
de
witnesses?
542, dis-je.
Thank you, Mr. President, and good morning, Your Honour.
Combien de temps avez-vous
we anticipate in relation to
bonjour.
TCW 766
pour le premier témoin, 766
that we will take approximately two sessions or half a day. This is obviously on the basis that I believe the Chamber has indicated that Your Honours will lead the examination of this witness
vous allez diriger
and the prosecution
témoin,
will follow
et
will obviously try and complement your examination and not repeat any of the areas you've covered.
Chercheront
so
à ne pas répéter
that
les renseignements que vous avez déjà obtenus, simplement
with respect
votre
to TCW
donc une demi-journée devrait suffire pour ce qui est du prochain témoin 542.
Again here, we will try to be as efficient as we
plus,
can.
Nous essaierons de faire comme d'autres
we believe
que possible.
Not more than three sessions would be required, approximately 4 hours.
Donc à peu près 4 heures.
There again, we'll try and be as quick as we can. It may well be possible to complete that examination
vite.
In half a day.
Il serait même possible
but if
que
a level of flexibility could be accommodated,
mais si l'on
we'll certainly
nous
try
and
be as quick as we
souplesse
can.
Pour,
and also, Your Honours, while I'm on my feet, you indicated
alors que j'ai la parole,
yesterday
vais
that
en pour
it might be helpful if the prosecution
would
provide
vous aviez dit qu'il serait utile si l'accusation
version,
pouvait
an updated version of the evidence from the prosecution indicating which of the documents originate or were received from DC CAM. We believe that we're in a position to do this by Tuesday, which I think was the time requested by my learned friend. We will attempt to, in fact, do that even earlier. But we believe that by Tuesday we can have all of those lists provided to the Chamber and the other parties, indicating, as I said, for each document, how many of them came from DC CAM.
President, thank you,
le président.
Prosecutor.
Je vous remercie.
We like now to inquire from the lead co-lawyers
nous posons maintenant la question
parties,
aux co-avocats pour les parties civiles,
for the two witnesses.
Les deux témoins.
How much time do you anticipate
quelle est la durée estimée de
for questioning
votre interrogatoire
each of
de
witnesses?
Ces deux témoins
being, good morning, Mr. President. Good morning, Your Honours, and good
bonjour,
morning,
Monsieur
everyone.
Président. Bonjour, Madame, Messieurs les juges. Et
for the
et
lead co-lawyers in questioning the true witnesses, we would need
les
2 hours for each witness.
Nous aurions besoin de 2 heures pour chacun des
témoins. For TCW 542, we need 2 hours. Likewise for TCW
766,
we need 2 hours.
2 heures aussi.
Thank you, Mr. President. What about Nguyen Chia's defense? How much time do you anticipate?
Équipe de défense de Nguyen Chia. Maintenant.
Thank you. For the, I had a brief discussion
merci.
With my colleagues on, for the defense.
Avec mon confrère.
We envisaged that for the first
nous
witness,
anticipons
7, 6, 6,
all defense teams together,
les équipes de défense toutes ensemble,
will need one or one and a half days,
besoin d'une journée et demie.
And we can divide the time amongst each other.
Et nous pouvons nous répartir le temps entre nous.
That's a very rough estimate, of course,
bien sûr
because we are last in the queue, and we don't know how many questions will have been asked,
ne savons pas exactement
and how many points will need further clarification. It's a very rough estimate.
Et quelles seront
and
for the other witness,
half a day
une demi-journée
for my own cross-examination.
Pour moi.
Sorry, we haven't discussed that particular witness
de défense,
yet.
Nous n'avons pas encore discuté de ce témoin avec les autres équipes de défense.
President, thank you. Defense counsel.
Le président.
What about Ian Sari's defense team?
Qu'en est-il de l'équipe?
How much time do you anticipate for TCW 542?
De combien de temps avez-vous besoin pour le TCW 542?
Ian Sari's defense.
Maître
Mr. President, for TCW 542. We need roughly 1 to 1.5 hours.
D'une heure à une heure et demie pour ce témoin.
As for TCW 766,
pour TCW 766,
we support the suggested time by Nuntia's defense that all the defense teams would need 1 to 1.5 days.
L'équipe de défense de Nuntia.
Thank you.
Nuntia, et pour dire que un jour et demi devrait suffire.
What about Kyo Sampan's
defense? Qu'en est-il de Kyo Sampan, demande le président.
How much time you anticipate for TCW 542?
Pouvez-vous nous indiquer la durée estimée de votre interrogatoire du témoin 542?
Thank you, Mr. President, for TCW 542.
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
We
pour ce témoin, nous aurons besoin
minutes
entre 15
to 1 hour.
Minutes et une heure.
As for TCW
766,
I agree with what has been suggested by Mr. Pesman.
Je suis d'accord avec la proposition de Maître Pesman.
All the defense teams agree to that time suggestion. Thank you, says the President.
Merci.
Thank you for the estimation of
le président,
time
merci
for
pour
these
ces
two
indications.
Witnesses that we plan to schedule for early next week.
Pour les deux témoins prévus.
This
aux audiences de la semaine prochaine.
Facilitate us in the scheduling of the true witnesses.
Voilà qui permettra une bonne planification des audiences.
We now hand over to the prosecution
la parole, l'accusation.
To continue with their arguments in response to the objections raised by the defense teams.
Par les équipes de défense.
Regarding A4 Annex.
Sur le sujet de l'annexe 4.
I remind the prosecution you have remaining 30 minutes.
Au procureur qu'il ne vous reste qu'une demi-heure.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Le procureur.
Je vous remercie. Time is short, and
je dispose de
our learned
de
friends
temps.
Obviously made a number of objections to this document category yesterday. What I intend to do is deal as quickly as I can with some of the issues that were raised, or perhaps the most important issues that were raised by the defense.
Des questions les plus importantes,
and then in the remaining time,
en premier lieu,
show
et, dans
a few documents
qui restera,
that in our submission,
je montrerai quelques documents
from which you can see in our submission that reliability and relevance are established. In all cases, simply by looking at the documents and conducting basic due diligence.
Et la pertinence
in reviewing the case file.
Simplement faisant preuve de diligence raisonnable.
So turning first to the objections
tout d'abord,
made by
les exceptions
Nuancier's
par l'équipe
team.
De défense de Nuancier.
I think the core set of objections I think related to the issue of relevance and whether or not all of these documents are relevant. To the first
si
trial
ces
in this case.
Sont pertinents pour
it's always a little bit unfortunate, Your Honours, when we find that facts are
souvent
misstated
de voir,
by our learned friends. There was
an
implication, I think, that the prosecutors were suggesting had filed this list in relation to the first trial
pour
and that
procès,
This was a list prepared following the severance order, which of course is not true.
These lists were filed in April,
to be more exact, on the 19th of April, and of course a second version of that of those same lists was filed in July, and that list indicated documents which we considered relevant to the first phase of the trial. It was only following the submission of those lists that Your Honours issued the severance order on the 22nd of September. And of course, in that severance order, Your Honours indicated that although this first trial will deal with the two specific sets of crimes that you have indicated, that additional crimes may be added. And furthermore, in your decision on our request for reconsideration of severance, and that is document E124/7, Your Honours indicated that in considering the addition of further crimes, in addition to those first two criminal episodes, that you would be guided by the OCP's recommendations. And you attached to that decision a list of relevant paragraphs for this first trial, and those paragraphs include all of the sections of the indictment dealing with the structures, the authority structures, communications mechanisms, the ministries of Democratic Cambodia, the authority structures of the Communist Party of Cambodia, and so forth. All of the parts of the indictment dealing with the establishment and operations of this regime are relevant, they are a part of this first trial, whether the sense like it or not. In no less than 142 paragraphs of the indictment, the investigating judges dealt with the operations and the structure of this regime. And of course, all of these documents go to proving the existence of an authority structure, the communications within that authority structure, and the ways in which the accused issued their orders and were able to ensure the implementation of the criminal plan which is alleged in the closing order. Your Honours further indicated that, of course, the accused must confront all allegations contained in the indictment, and of course you did that in the scheduling order for the opening statements, and that was document E131. There can be no suggestion that these documents which relate to the operations and the structure of the regime and the communication systems are somehow not relevant to this first trial. I'll try and deal very quickly with some of the examples that my learned friend gave. But before I do that, I'd like to also just make reference to the way in which the defence has approached its obligations in this respect. The Nguyen Chia team, in fact, has refused to submit any list of evidence, has indicated, in fact, that they will...
I apologise to the interpreters.
They have, in fact, indicated that they will file any documents which they consider relevant at any time that they consider appropriate. And they did so in their observations, document D109/3, and it was disappointing, I think, to hear our friends yesterday indicate that, that we are here at a risk of drowning in evidential material which has been classified, catalogued, summarised and provided, and which has been on the case file for 2 or 3 years and in many cases longer. The prosecution has done its due diligence, and we simply invite the defence to do the same. With respect to the specific examples that were cited, again, it was unfortunate that counsel, in referring to the specific examples, didn't read the entire entry that was being referred to. For example, there was reference to document number 165 in our list. This is, in fact, document introductory submission 21.16. Of course, this document, like the other telegrams, is proffered in many cases simply because it shows the existence of a regular, structured, and hierarchical communication system which was in place throughout the period covered by the indictment. And if my friend had looked at the page that he was citing,
lu la page qu'il citait,
for entry 165, relevance is of course indicated
sur la ligne 165,
in the very line which, from which he was reading.
La pertinence,
and we indicate there that the relevance is the operation of offices of 870 and the communication structures. Furthermore, Your Honours, had our friend done a simple word search in the closing order, he would have found this document is in fact referred in paragraph 77 of the closing order, which, as I indicated earlier, is of course a part of this, of the,
of the sections of the indictment,
which are the subject of this first trial.
We
have limited time, so I'm unable to go through all of the examples. But again, a simple due diligence search indicates that each document is relevant. And ultimately, of course, as we've indicated, telegrams show the existence of a structured communication system through which the accused ensured the implementation of the common criminal plan. Another example, document 359 was cited. Again, Your Honours, the list clearly indicates the relevance of that document to be the communication structure and the Nguyen Chia's involvement in the common criminal plan. The document itself is cited again in the closing order at paragraph 876, which again is before Your Honours in this first trial. And lastly, I'll just refer to one more document, document 365 on our list. Again, relevance is indicated in the document from which my friend was reading. It relates to the operations of offices of 870 and again to the existence of structured channels of communication. And furthermore, a basic search of the case file would have indicated that this document was in fact an attachment to a witness statement.
This witness was
interviewed by the office of the co-investigating judges. This witness is TCW604, and the witness has been identified by Your Honours as a trial witness. So again, in relation to that document, there is more than enough indication both of its relevance
and the way in which it
can be further examined by the court and the other parties. In response to Ying Sari's team, again, try and be very brief. There was indication that it would be appropriate, and it's certainly international practice, indicates that in where telegram communications or radio intercepts are at issue, that it is appropriate to call either the authors of those communications, or if the authors are not available, then in some cases
people
who are familiar with the systems
can be called.
Of course, that's exactly the approach Your Honours have taken in this case. There are several telegram operators who have been scheduled to testify. This is, in fact, the next group of witnesses who will be testifying. So my friend is correct in saying that it is appropriate to hear telegram operators. I'll just give a few examples. We have TCW695,
TCW398,
TCW480, TCW307, etc. All of these witnesses are either telegram operators or telegram decoders. They are former junior cadre or staff of various offices of Democratic Cambodia, both in Phnom Penh and in other parts of the country. With respect to the documents that were referred to by my friend, counsel for Mr. Ying Sari, there was a reference, number of questions were asked as to who are the people mentioned in these documents. Of course, in many cases, the witnesses will provide such information, but even more immediately, that information is available in the closing order.
Quoi qu'il en soit,
it is available on a very basic search of the case file.
Dans le dossier,
in relation to 21.14, my friend asked who is hanged.
Well,
Your Honours, if you do a search of the closing order, the answer is there.
Hang
was, of course, Bouffat, former secretary of Sector 103. He's referred in paragraphs 425 and 943 of the closing order. His confession from S21 is on the case file, and that document is D159/5.4. Not only that, Your Honours, the secretary who replaced this individual is himself a witness, has been called by Your Honours, and he is TCW428. Another example given by my friend was D366/7.1.793. authored by an individual called Nim. Our friend was asking who Nim was, on a basic search of the closing Nim order. Numerous references to Ross Nim, secretary of the Northwest Zone, who is described a paragraph 1262 of the closing order. In fact, at paragraph 958 of the closing order, the investigating judges quote Duchess' statement, and I quote, Nuancia also had Ross Nim arrested, who was his brother-in-law and secretary of the Northwest Zone. Plenty of information about these individuals in the case file. I'll skip a couple of examples and just deal with one, which perhaps may have appeared at face value to be unusual. My friend referred to D199/14.2. This was a postcard, a copy of a postcard. The question was asked as to perhaps why this is relevant.
Of course, Your Honours,
this again is an item which is referred to in the closing order. Not only is it referred to in the closing order, it's actually described in some detail. And if you look at paragraph 1094, the second part of that paragraph explains that this individual was in fact a diplomat in Senegal, a Democratic Kampuchea cadre who was recalled according to the indictment back to Cambodia. And of course, found himself arrested and imprisoned at age 21 within 4 days of arrival. The relevance of the postcard, of course, as the closing order explains, is that it was sent from Beijing en route back to Cambodia, where this gentleman was informing his family about his intended arrival in Phnom Penh. Tragically, of course, he was killed. Further information about that case is contained in the witness interview of that gentleman's wife, and that witness interview is D199/14. Your Honours, clearly, for any of these documents that were referred to by the defence, a simple due diligence exercise and a review of the case file provides both the indicia of reliability and clearly the indicia of relevance to the issues that we're dealing with.
Et les indices de fiabilité pour les documents et pertinents pour les questions qui nous occupent.
Turning now to some examples that weren't raised by my friends, but which in our submission demonstrate how these collections must be viewed as a whole and how these documents must be examined in light of other evidence which supports both their relevance and reliability. I'll deal with as many documents as I can in the time that is remaining. Just by way of overview, the Annex 4DK communications, there are 393 documents which we identified as relevant to the first phase of the trial. I think Your Honour's memo might have indicated 394. There might be a difference there of one. We think the number might be 393. Out of these 393, a total of 168 documents were admitted by Your Honours in case one. So based obviously an exercise of review of relevance and reliability was undertaken in that case, and we would say certainly for the purposes of reliability that where an exhibit was admitted in case one, there is a strong presumption, obviously, that those documents are reliable, that they are what they purport to be, and of course the test being prima facie reliability. And as I've indicated before, relevance again is indicated for each of them. The communications, as my friend indicated yesterday, are comprised of five types of documents. They are DK telegrams, reports, letters, notes, and orders. With respect to each subcategory, there are a number of ways of ascertaining relevance and reliability. They include, of course, testimonial evidence that is on the case file, witness statements, telegram operators, former cadre, including those whom I referred to earlier, and a few examples that I will show. And, of course, these documents, when you consider them, we would submit that you need to consider them as a whole, as a series of documents. And I will give just one example. I believe some 13 documents were authored by an individual called Lang, And in fact, he authored some of the documents with his alias Lang, and then some of them are authored with his name, with his alias Chan. Of course, Your Honours, this was the Secretary of Independent Sector 105.
The circumstances
of his death and his responsibilities for Sector 105 are described in the closing order,
described in numerous witness statements,
and as it turns out, two witnesses who have been called are his close family members. They are TCW 695 and TCW 307. And when you look at those 13 telegrams, you see obviously that they deal with a series of events. There's a certain internal consistency as to the events being described. And there is obviously reliability through testimonial evidence on the case file. And so documents must, Your Honours, be viewed, we submit, in groups and, of course, in relation to other evidence which indicates or corroborates their contents. I will not now try and demonstrate that by referring to a few examples in the time that we have remaining, and dealing first with the DK telegrams. Mr. President, if we could now show a document that is on our screen, or it should be on our screen shortly.
President, yes, you're authorized to do so. You still have 12 minutes left.
Projeter ce document, il vous reste 12 minutes.
Thank you, Mr. President. This is an example of a telegram.
C'est un exemple
in this telegram. Case, it appears that we have, the co-investigating judges have in fact obtained an original or a photograph of the original document. And of course, a senior staff member of DC CAM has indicated that this document is available in its original form. This is the Khmer version, of course. The statement of the DC CAM staff member is D311/2. If we scroll down to the bottom of this page, we've actually redacted, I believe, the name of the author of this telegram. That's because the author is, in fact, TCW 604, a witness whom Your Honours have scheduled to appear before you. In his statement, D201/5, he indicates that he wrote this document himself.
Dans sa déposition, donc,
again, Your Honours, looking to the relevance of this document,
de ce
the contents of the document are of some interest.
Le contenu des documents,
but certainly, insofar as they relate to the searching for, as they were called, UON spies. But more broadly, as I indicated earlier, the relevance, again, is the establishment of a regular and structured reporting system, which was in place throughout the period covered by the indictment. Mr. President, if I could move on to another document. And this is D175/6.13. If we can show that document on the screen, if that's appropriate.
Yes, you may proceed.
Le président, oui, allez-y.
Again, Your Honours, I'll only show the Khmer version, given that the time is limited. Again, in this case, this appears to be an original. Again, at D311/2, a senior staff member of DC CAM indicates that an original is available. Another document authored by the same cadre, who happens to be the Secretary of the Northeast Zone, was admitted by Your Honours in Case 1, so another document from the same series has already been admitted. That document is D175/6.15. And lastly, in relation to this document, it has in fact been authenticated by a witness, and that witness is TCW 480. He is scheduled to testify shortly before Your Honours. In fact, not only does he discuss the telegram, he was able to discuss the handwriting on the telegram, which indicates that this document was to be a copy of this document was to be given to Yang Sary. If I may move on to another example of a telegram. If we could show on the screen document, introductory submission IS 21.146, if that's appropriate.
Si vous m'y autorisez.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
This is, in fact, if we could have that document on the screen,
peut-on
please.
Projeter ce document à l'écran?
Thank you.
Merci.
Again, I will show only a Khmer version, given that we have limited time. This is a document from the Commerce Committee in Phnom Penh, addressed to comrades Prin and Nat. Comrade Nat was in fact Pal Va, as other evidence on the case file indicates. She was the wife of an individual called Ing Sok. Together, Ing Sok and his wife Pal Va were located in Hong Kong, where, as again evidence indicates, they were in charge of the Ren Fung Company, through which Democratic Cambodia conducted its international trade. And of course, a reference was made yesterday to the fact that these offices were very much under the authority of the accused Khieu Samphan. The contents of this document are interesting insofar as other documents then indicate what happened after this telegram was sent. This telegram was, directing Nat and her children to return to Phnom Penh. The husband, Ing Sok, was also to return. And, Your Honours, if we can again show two documents on the screen, we have a prisoner sheet, which is document IS 3.1, if we could have that on the screen.
Qui porte sur un prisonnier.
If we could show that document, this is introductory submission 3.1.
IS 3.1, peut-on le faire apparaître à
l'écran? This is the prisoner sheet of Ing Sok,
c'est une
alias
liste de prisonniers,
I apologize, of Pal Va,
de Pal Va, alias Nat,
and that indicates that she entered S21 on the 30th of December 1972, only 20 days after that telegram was sent to Hong Kong.
We
will show another prisoner sheet, which is that of her husband. This is introductory submission 3.1. I apologize, the wife's prisoner sheet was 3.5, and the husband's is 3.1. If we could return back to our screen just for a moment to show again how these documents come together, I would like to show you some photographs which are on the case file, again, as part of IS 3.5. If we could show that on the screen, Your Honours. I think we have about 2 minutes left.
Je pense qu'il nous reste environ 2 minutes.
If we can, this is 3.5. There on the left-hand side, you see Pal Va alias Nat, a photograph taken in Hong Kong, and on the right-hand side, her photograph taken at
S21.
And last but not least, the circumstances of the arrest and of the return to Cambodia and the arrest of these individuals are discussed by Tuch in his written record before the co-investigating judges, document D-119. Your Honours, I had anticipated or had intended to deal with each
J'avais
of the subcategories, and we have numerous more examples like
Nous
these,
de
where
exemples
telegrams,
celui-ci.
Letters,
Il
orders,
de telegram, de lettres, ou d'ordre,
and notes,
et de notes,
as well as reports,
et de rapports,
contain information that is corroborated by other documents,
par
they contain information that is
documents.
Often discussed by
Ce
witnesses. And of course, in as far as we're dealing with telegrams
témoins,
or letters, reports specifically, several cadres explain the circumstances in which such documents were prepared. They describe the systems that were used, and they will of course describe for Your Honours specific markings that illustrate that these are Democratic Cambodia and Communist Party of Cambodia documents and records.
Les annotations, les marques.
I think that
a posé sur ces documents qui les identifient comme étant les documents du Cambodge démocratique.
I think I've run out of time, Your Honours. I'm happy to discuss any of the other categories if Your Honours deem that appropriate.
Si vous l'estimez utile, je serai prêt à parler des autres catégories, mais entre-temps, je resterai là.
President, thank you.
Le président.
International
Je remercie le coprocureur international.
Next, the chamber hands over
La chambre va à présent
to the
entendre
lead co-lawyers
les co-avocats principaux pour les parties civiles.
To respond to the objections
Ceux-ci auront
by
l'occasion
the defense teams
de répondre aux objections soulevées par les différentes équipes de défense.
Documents in Annex 4. You may now proceed.
Des documents énumérés à l'annexe 4. Je vous
Mr. Payang, good morning, Pika. Mr. President.
Bonjour,
we
Monsieur
would like
le
to
Président.
Delegate this submission to Mr. Lau Chun-Ti,
donner la parole à Maître
lawyer
Lau
from
Chun-Ti
the Legal Aid of Cambodia,
de l'équipe Legal Aid of Cambodia.
President, your request is
le
granted. So, Mr. Lau Chun-Ti, you may now proceed.
Vous y autorisons. Je vous en prie, Maître Lau Chun-Ti.
Mr. Lau Chun-Ti.
Maître Lau Chun-Ti.
Good morning, Mr. President.
Bonjour,
good morning,
Monsieur
Your Honor.
Président, Madame, Messieurs les juges.
And good morning,
Bonjour
everyone.
À toutes les personnes
My name is
ici présentes.
Lau Chun-Ti.
Je m'appelle
I am
Lau Chun-Ti.
A civil party lawyer
Je suis
in case
avocat
002.
Des parties civiles dans le cadre du dossier 002.
And I would like to respond to the objections raised by the defense
aux objections soulevées par la défense
against documents listed in Annex 4.
S'agissant des documents énumérés à l'annexe 4.
According to the document E19 on point 8, document,
document
E
9/31.3
In that document, there are document E109/4.4
E109/4.4
And there are 394 documents in this annex.
Dans cet annexe, on trouve 384
I would like
documents.
To make observation on two points.
J'ai des observations à faire sur deux points.
First, I would like to
Premièrement.
Look at the overall context.
Je voudrais m'étendre sur
so that we can examine the
context.
Potential of having all of those documents before the chamber, and we can ensure that those documents authenticity and reliability can be proved before the chamber. Then I will look
context,
at
A,
the
Je vais premièrement
reality of the document, and B, I am going to point to the sources
Ensuite,
of those documents. And
je
see
de leur source,
the custody of the document.
Je parlerai de leur filière de conservation.
Now, A, we look at the reality of the document. What is the general format of the document put before your before the chamber?
Quel
As
est le
the
format
prosecutor has expressly mentioned in their submission that this document had an instruction from the management. And of course, that those documents as well also indicated the purpose of the
On
document and why it was
document,
produced in the first place.
Et quant à sa raison d'être.
So when we see the format of those documents
Examinons
as well as the purpose of producing those documents,
documents
they reveal the reliability
finalité.
Of those documents that can be used as evidence before the chamber. And then B, we are going to look at the sources of
Ensuite,
those documents.
Je vous invite
of course,
à examiner
those documents
la source
were originated from the Democratic Cambodia period between 1975 to 1979. Then we should continue to look at the very reason why those documents were produced.
Les raisons pour lesquelles ces documents ont été établis.
What agents produced this document, as the prosecutor pointed out, there were witnesses who can testify on this document as to how they were produced. And what is the overall characteristic of those documents?
Sur les caractéristiques
was it the directive or communicated message? Actually, those documents are the administrative documents used to share information among members of the Democratic Cambodia. They can be reports, they can be telegrams, and various other documents. This is a demonstration that during that regimes, there was a clear structure, administrative structure in the Democratic Cambodia. Now I move on to point C. There have been a collection of those documents and a chain of custody of those documents. In 1995, Documentation Center of Cambodia, an organization,
en 1995, le centre de documentation du Cambodge,
the various documents from the Democratic Cambodia. Of course, immediately following the fall of the Democratic Cambodia, Cambodian people were not interested in collecting information because they had to do something in order to fill their stomach rather than collecting those documents. So it was this institution, Documentation Center of Cambodia, which strive to locate the remaining documents in search for truth. And of course, when there was a cooperation between the government of Cambodia and the United Nations, jointly established this tribunal, then we would have to look for assistance from this organization to provide necessary information. And we also receive information from the National Archive, as well as the Toolsline Archive, and from individual donations, because those people may have at hand the documents. So they send those documents to the Documentation Center of Cambodia. So the point I would like to make here is that if we try to find the individuals who proffer those documents, it may be more than difficult in this context.
De
and as for the custody
qui
of documents
de ces
from those days until now, of course, it
pour ce qui est de la conservation
can
des documents,
be established.
Celle-ci peut être reconstituée.
Now I move to the second point, which is the direct response to the objection raised by the defense.
Aux objections.
The defense referred to the jurisprudence from the ICTY. And in the ICTY trial chamber, the defense argued that they summoned those who prepared the telegram to testify in the court. Of course, here we can ask them to come to court as well. But if you look at the context we have now, it has been some 30 years or so already, and some of those responsible for telegram communication might have passed away, or they may be too old. So as the prosecutor says, certain lucky individuals who survive the regimes and survive until to date can, of course, appear before this chamber to testify. So the reliance on the jurisprudence from the ICTY, it is, of course, good, as I said,
but
Of course, we have to be objective in our context. The witnesses that you are requesting or demanding, they may be too old already, or they might have already passed away.
Sont parfois trop vieux, ou d'autres encore sont décédés.
Another point of relevance.
J'en viens au point suivant.
The defense also raised the objection against the confession by torture. I think the prosecution has responded very well to this point.
L'accusation a bien répondu à cet argument.
But I believe that there will be more debate on this very subject at a later stage.
Cette question sera débattue de façon plus approfondie ultérieurement.
Now I would like to talk about the civil parties.
Je voudrais à présent
they
parler
mentioned
des parties
that
civiles.
There were some 4,000 civil parties in the case file, but actually the actual number of civil parties in this case is 3,866.
La partie adverse dit qu'il y a 4,000 parties civiles dans le cadre
and
de ce dossier, or le chiffre exact est de 3,866.
Who may be heard by the court accounts for around 150 civil parties.
Et il
and
y a
among 150 civil parties, only a small minority of them will testify before
or,
this chamber.
Une petite partie de ces 50 personnes
so
veut effectivement
would,
comparaître.
Suggest my learned colleagues from the defense that you should not be too worried about the number of the civil parties to
Je
testify before this court.
Donc à mon éminent confrère de la défense de ne pas
in addition, the civil parties who come to testify before
déposer.
This court the
en fait,
party. So please don't be confused. They are not going to come here to testify as witness, but they are
Ces parties civiles
the civil parties.
Ne viendront pas déposer en tant que témoins, mais bien en tant que partie civile.
Another important point which I would like to also address in response to the defense.
J'en viens au point suivant. En réponse aux arguments
you
de la défense.
You mentioned that even if there was a name of your client in the telegram,
défense,
but you were wondering whether
si
or not your client
le nom
has actually received those telegrams
sur le
or
point
letters.
De savoir si
of course, at that time, there were the so-called
question.
Messenger. Messenger received the letter from one institution and conveyed it to another institution. So Messenger is one of the important and most reliable person to convey
les
message. And the messenger are generally loyal to their organization, particularly they were responsible for sending message from
Ces
one institution to another. And at that time, some of them even used a horse in order to deliver message quickly.
Organes,
as for the question whether or not the individual person has received or not received the document, so we will have to
si
question
le
that
destinataire
messenger.
Prévu a effectivement reçu
of
les documents
course,
en question,
this is
il faudrait poser la question au messager.
The,
voilà donc ma réponse
objection raised by the defense,
à l'objection
that,
soulevée par la défense,
name of
comme
the
quoi,
client, but, you were
même
still
si
doubtful
le nom
d'un
accusé figure dans un document,
that message.
Cela
course,
ne veut pas nécessairement dire
the person
que
must
l'accusé
have
a reçu ce message.
Document D366/7.1.338. By reviewing this document, we note the format,
nous pouvons constater quel est son format,
content of the document, and there was also a date
contenu.
On that document.
On constate
so
que
it
ce
means
document
that this
daté.
Kind of document is quite clear. So we can respond to the defense that by mere looking at this paper, we know that, of course, the person who prepared this document must have been trained or skillful in preparing these reports or documents. Of course, if they were illiterate or did not know anything, they could not prepare such a
document. De cette nature.
A telegram D108/28.1.
Je voudrais à présent vous parler du télégramme qui porte la cote D108/21.8.
And the first line on the left, there is a number 31.
À la première ligne à gauche, on trouve le chiffre 31.
Telegram was addressed to
M,
beloved M870. So this was the language used during that period, and it was copied to Brother Nguyen, Brother Van, Brother Q, and
archives.
So this is the procedure by which the document was kept during that period. Another document, the 108/226.81.
Je voudrais vous parler du document D108/226.81.
Said it was illegible.
La défense prétend que ce document est illisible.
Of course, this document was typewritten. More than 30 years ago, and it may have been some quality deterioration.
Certes,
however, the upper part of this document was quite clear because there is a salutation which mentioned the person whom this letter or this telegram was addressed, and it refers to May 1976.
Et on y trouve également la date du mois de mai 1976.
And the person who sent this telegram was also mentioned in the bottom on the bottom of the telegram. So it means that this was consistent. So these are some of the realities concerning the documents in Annex 4,
voilà,
and I would like to ask the chamber to to consider these documents, particularly taking into account the facts which I have presented, and I believe that those documents are reliable, and they are of course relevant to the case before Your Honor, and of course those documents can therefore be admitted before the chamber. Thank you.
En conséquence de quoi, ces documents devraient être déclarés recevables.
The President, thank you.
Le Président,
Council.
Je vous remercie, Maître.
Now, we continue hearing the objections regarding contemporaneous DK documents that the trial chamber intends to place before it.
Documents contemporains.
We will continue with the objection relating to documents in A5 category. The defense has been allocated 1 hour
la défense dispose
to present its objection, and it was left to the discretion of the defense how to divide
la défense
its time
avait la
among
possibilité
themselves.
De se répartir le
I
temps
therefore
parole.
Now hand over to
Je vais donc
Nunjia
donner
defense,
la parole
first.
À l'équipe de défense de Nunjia tout d'abord.
You may proceed.
Je vous en prie.
Thank you, Your Honor.
La défense de Nunjia. Merci.
I'll keep it brief.
Je serai concis.
In order to avoid unnecessary repetition.
Pour éviter toute répétition utile.
DCCAM documents, we've discussed those
pour ce qui est
at length.
Des documents du DCCAM, nous en avons déjà
we welcome the announcement the prosecution made this morning that they will provide everyone with a list of documents received from DCCAM,
liste des documents provenant du DCCAM.
And we're looking forward to studying that.
Après quoi, nous allons étudier cette liste.
Of course, the admission of those documents, as we have said many times this week, is subject to the hearing of
Hugh Cheng in court. And comme nous l'avons déjà dit,
us, defense, giving the opportunity to cross-examine him. As far as the relevance is concerned, the prosecutor made some remarks on the relevance of certain documents, and we agree the scope of the first mini-trial is not limited to the evacuation of Phnom Penh or the first movement of people from north or from south to north. The topic of the first trial is also the hierarchy of the party, the command structure, communications within the DK. We take the position, however, and we disagree with the prosecutor, that when your trial chamber will look at those topics, so those additional issues
examinera ces points,
relevant for the structure of the country, the party, the government, that emphasis should lie on the relevant period, for the evacuation of Phnom Penh,
à savoir celle de
and the phase two
de
movement of population.
Et du, la phase deux des déplacements de population.
Just to give you one example,
je prends un exemple.
The prosecution was giving examples this morning.
L'accusation a elle-même donné des
exemples ce matin. Whether Ian Tirit was informed in July 1978, which is 2 years after the relevant period, whether she was informed on the political consciousness of midwives in a particular hospital,
we
maintain is completely irrelevant for the first mini-trial. It doesn't say anything of any relevance to the first mini-trial. Even if it says something about the structure of that particular ministry in 1978, it only confuses the things that we have to discuss in the first mini-trial. So we maintain that the emphasis should lie when we discuss the structure of the party and the government. The emphasis should lie on the first period, the period relevant for the evacuation of Phnom Penh
celle qui concerne
and the subsequent
de
movement
Penh,
of people from
que le déplacement
south to north.
Qui a suivi du sud vers le nord.
What we are afraid of, what we are afraid of that is going to happen, is that the prosecutor will take this opportunity to introduce evidence into this first mini-trial in order to extend the scope of this first mini-trial. I think a very good example was given this morning by the OCP when they showed us several documents related to S21 as the alleged purge of a person who worked in Hong Kong for an office established by DK
se trouvait à Hong Kong dans un bureau
trade purposes.
Établi à l'étranger par le Cambodge démocratique à des
whether
fins commerciales.
This office was purged,
le point de savoir si ce bureau
whether cadres from this office were sent to S21, S21 was established,
ont été envoyés
as you know, after
S21,
the evacuation of Phnom Penh,
lorsqu'il a été mis en place
and whether any of the accused knew about this.
L'un quelconque des accusés en avait connaissance, tout cela,
we maintain, is completely irrelevant
est dénué de
for this first mini-trial.
Dans le cadre
it
de
is not on
mini-procès.
Your agenda. We will
cela
discuss this that later
au programme. Cela sera
to
examiné
great extent without any doubt.
Sans aucun doute. Et de façon approfondie.
I again invite the trial chamber to look at the list of documents provided by the prosecutor with a very critical eye
sous un angle
and to
très critique,
discard as irrelevant
en écartant
all evidence which really has nothing to
de
do
manque, de
with the scope
tout élément
of the first mini-trial.
Rapport avec la portée du premier mini-procès.
With regard to the other documents,
concernant les autres documents,
documents which are prima facie relevant for the first mini-trial
vue,
and documents which have not been provided by DCCAM,
s'agissant des documents qui n'ont pas été fournis
we
par
repeat
le DCCAM,
our position
nous répétons
as explained
notre
earlier this
position,
week,
telle que nous avons déjà exposé cette
that,
semaine,
that evidence is admissible,
à savoir que ces preuves sont recevables,
If those documents contain evidence on the role of our client or evidence on key issues in the first mini trial, then we maintain that those documents should be put before our client, our client is testifying, and that if necessary, the author of that particular document should be heard in court. Thank you very much.
President, thank you, Council. The National Defense Council, you may proceed.
La parole est à l'avocat cambodgien de Kusampa, de Nung Chia.
Somgarup.
Maître
Sonarun. Thank you, Mr. President. Good morning, Mr. President. Your Honours. Good morning,
je vous remercie. Everyone. Bonjour, Monsieur le Président. Bonjour, Madame, Messieurs les juges et tous et toutes ici présents.
In Annex 5, that is document A9/31.4.
Document
E9/31.5. There are various reports from one individual to another, or from the upper hierarchy to the lower hierarchy, or from the upper offices to the lower cadres, or from one institution to
le haut et vice versa,
another institution, or from one region to another region.
D'une région à l'autre.
The Grunk statements
les
made by Norodom Sihanouk on the composition of the Grunk government,
la composition du gouvernement du Grunk,
on the 5th of October 1974,
was
published in the Funk regarding the information from Cambodia.
Le Funk.
The 366/71.455. That is also IS.
Il existe aussi le document IS.
18.1 to IS
12.3.
There are also reports from the DK government.
Aussi
that is the document D262.13 and various other reports, as well as the statements by the government, including the media report by the
Cambodia
Democratic,
et aussi d'autres rapports médiatiques du Cambodia Democratic,
talking about the aggression by the Vietnamese soldier,
de l'agression par les soldats vietnamiens. Un rapport fait par Tran Van Thai, c'est un soldat vietnamien arrêté par le Cambodia Démocratique dans le cadre de l'agression vietnamienne et qui a avoué
le 24
janvier 1978 au document IS 12.26.
Regarding the DK, the Fung, the Grung, rather, telegrams made by Norodom Sihanouk, statement by the DK government,
du gouvernement du Cambodia Démocratique et d'autres documents de ce type,
talked mainly about their daily activities,
font surtout état de leurs activités quotidiennes. Et si ces documents
genuine documents
sont des documents authentiques,
authenticity
dont l'authenticité
from the original copies, whether they were obtained
en comparant
by
avec l'original,
or verifiable
s'ils ont
sources,
été obtenus soit par des CKM ou des sources
Mr.
fiables,
Nunchia,
mon client, Nunchia,
respond to the allegations made by the prosecution
aux allégations avancées par l'accusation, et ce, sans aucune hésitation.
As we repeatedly urge the chamber to order the prosecution to present the original documents,
les documents
so that my client is in a position to compare
afin que mon
the copies
soit en mesure
we have
de
at hand
la copie
the original documents
à son original
before he can acknowledge whether they are actually the documents
si
produced
document,
during the
si les documents
DK period.
s'il s'agit bel et bien de documents produits pendant la période du Cambodge démocratique, et répondra alors aux allégations.
My clients Nong Chia, as well as us, the defense team, plus all other defense teams,
notre équipe de défense et les autres équipes de défense,
on this very topic, that is
sont du même avis sur
have
cette
our
question.
Hands on the original copies
nous voulons
regarding all those allegations made by the prosecutions,
les copies originales,
and not just rely on unverifiable sources
pour ces documents qui font état d'allégations sur nos clients, et pas simplement dépendre de copies comme preuve à charge.
That since 16th January 2012,
j'ai remarqué que depuis le 16 janvier 2012,
the chamber scheduled annex 1 through 5 in order to put them through debates in order to find justice and
organiser des débats sur les annexes 1 à 5 afin d'aider à établir la vérité.
I categorically denied or object to any allegations without basis by the prosecution,
sans fondement,
without any authentication of those documents by the prosecution.
C'est à moins que l'accusation ne vérifie l'authenticité des documents.
And as I already requested the chamber yesterday to present those documents put forward by the prosecution, those documents
faire produire
not
les originaux de ces documents
and we are not
présentés
sure
par l'accusation. Nous ne savons pas si ces documents sont vérifiables et nous ne savons pas s'il s'agit d'une véritable copie conforme à l'original.
Furthermore, during these 4 days, the prosecution
au cours des 4 derniers jours,
had failed to provide any concrete testimony as to how they obtained these thousands of documents and from
n'a pas démontré
whom or
comment
from where, and under
ils ont obtenu ces milliers de documents, par
we,
qui, d'où et sous quelles circonstances.
Cannot accept
les
this circumstance.
Défense,
the prosecution acknowledged those documents put
des choses.
The sequential numbers on those documents at their own discretion in order to incriminate my client.
Et on a mis des numéros
they do not
en
take
séquence
into account the
pour incriminer mon
fact
client.
Of trying to ascertain the truth
et l'on ne tient pas compte
for everyone and
du
for the general public.
Devoir de faire jaillir la lumière et de découvrir la vérité pour tous et toutes les parties pour la population.
The accused, I urge
au nom
your
de
honors to
l'accusé,
consider and to reject those
j'exhorte la Chambre
allegations
à rejeter
by
ces allégations sans fondement formulées par l'accusation.
And we, the Nong Chia defense team,
et l'équipe de défense de
Nong Chia
insiste
the
sur le fait que l'accusation doit présenter les originaux afin de vérifier l'authenticité de ces documents et d'établir la vérité en cette chambre.
Most of the documents the prosecution have in their hands
la majorité des documents
cannot be verified.
Que
we do not know the exact
ne peuvent pas être vérifiés. Nous ne connaissons pas les précisions, les dépositaires de ces documents.
How they were obtained.
Nous ne savons pas comment ces documents ont été obtenus.
Maintained.
Ou conservés.
They were circulated and gathered
ces documents
from everywhere around the country.
Sont passés d'une main à l'autre et proviennent de partout au pays.
Could the prosecution
comment
understand
l'accusation
that there could be the opposed factor of the DK who could manufacture those documents in order to incriminate
oublier
or
le
to
fait
put
que
the blame
des factions
of the DK
au sein
government.
Du Cambodge démocratique auraient pu fabriquer de telles montées de toutes pièces ces documents.
If they take that factor into consideration,
si
they might have a different
compte
view.
De cette possibilité, ils pourraient
for the
donc changer
political
d'avis.
Lawyers of the civil parties,
en réponse aux co-avocats principaux
in their response
pour les parties
to
civiles,
annex 4, that the people
qui, dans
who
leur
can testify to
réponse
this chamber,
aux objections soulevées pour l'annexe 4, que des gens peuvent
who are
venir, que
already
qui,
too old to testify, or some have already
que les personnes
passed away,
sont trop âgées
who can
ou
have
sont déjà
already
décédées
made
et ne peuvent venir comparaître et que celles qui l'ont
that
pu le faire ont déjà
all,
déposé auprès du tribunal, ce n'est pas vrai du tout.
I agree that there are people who can come here to testify.
Je suis d'accord.
Of course, there are old people and there are people who passed away.
Comparaître. Il y a certaines sont âgées, d'autres sont décédées. Celles qui numerous. Peuvent déposer sont nombreuses.
And they are not too old to testify.
Ils regarding ne sont pas the very subject matter before us today. Nunchi's defense already made several requests to the OCIJ
for the past 4 years.
Au co-juge d'instruction au cours des 4 dernières
and
années.
OCJ only selectively made some
et
interviews with certain people we requested.
Non
for the aforementioned reasons, I urge your honors to reject the allegation raised by the prosecution
à la chambre de rejeter les allégations
in Annex 5.
De l'accusation
and we still
dans
maintain that we urge the prosecution to present the
et
original documents
répétons notre
in order to verify the
authenticity
of those documents
de
before this very chamber and the general public. So that my client, Mr. Nunchi, can respond to the allegations by the prosecution and grateful to your honor.
President,
thank you, Defense Counsel.
Le Président, je vous remercie.
Yingsari's defense, you now have the floor.
La défense de Yingsari.
Good morning, Mr. President. Good morning, Your Honor. Good morning to everyone in and around the courtroom.
Bonjour, Monsieur le Président, Madame, Messieurs les juges, et tous et toutes ici présents.
I believe we have already amply noted our objections as to these
four
types of evidence
de nos
in our general in our general remarks.
À ce type d'éléments de preuve.
As we noted that media reports
dans nos
are in and of themselves unreliable unless
déclarations
some sort of
ne
indicia of reliability
fiable,
can be
à
shown,
moins que l'on puisse prouver qu'il existe des indices
especially when statements are attributed to
en particulier
our client or to the
lorsque
other
des
accused,
propos sont attribués soit à mon
client
ou à d'autres accusés.
Those, those purported statements or paraphrasing what our clients may have said
déclaration alléguée ou cette paraphrase de ce que
is taken at face value. We noted, for instance, one example in the past with respect to Elizabeth Becker, which dealt with the 1975 Mayaguez incident. We were then noted
à l'incident du
informed that we should simply look at Elizabeth
on nous a dit
Becker's
qu'on devrait tout simplement aller voir les notes d'Elizabeth Becker qui sont présentes au
and
dossier.
Therein would lie the answers.
Et
well,
que la réponse s'y trouverait.
To the case file
eh bien,
and look at her notes,
si vous consultez les
you
notes
d'Elizabeth
Becker dans le dossier pénal, on ne trouve rien
piece of evidence that is being sought to be introduced.
Par rapport
now,
à cet élément,
that said, we
enfin,
understand
cette pièce que l'on veut déposer comme preuve,
that the prosecution intends to introduce these sorts of types of evidence
nous
for various reasons.
Que l'accusation présente ces documents
and of course,
pour plusieurs raisons.
It would be up to you, Your Honors, to
et
determine whether those that piece of evidence can come in
de décider si
limited
ce
to
document
the purpose for which the prosecution intends to use that information.
Et limité à l'utilisation.
Of course, it would be up to the prosecution to inform the parties
que
exactly the purpose.
C'est à l'accusation, bien sûr, d'informer
we
les parties
submit,
de l'objectif.
And this is something that I will touch upon later this afternoon when we do our wrap-up remarks concerning our responses to all of these specific types of evidence, is that simply because something is in the case file
parce
or simply because something
dans le
is referenced in the closing order
ou qu'on y fait référence à l'ordonnance de clôture,
necessarily admissible
cela
for trial.
Ne lui confère pas un caractère de recevabilité
if that were the case,
automatique.
Then why are we bothering
si c'était
with this entire exercise?
Pourquoi sommes-nous ici aujourd'hui?
The entire case file can simply be used by any party.
On pourrait simplement utiliser le dossier pénal et toutes les parties
and so, simply to say, well, it's referenced in this
donc,
paragraph,
de
therein lies the answer.
De
our position
clôture,
is,
voilà notre réponse.
Be that as it may, at
cela,
some point,
nous ceci.
Since the prosecution bears the burden of proof,
comme
they will have to demonstrate
la charge
why
c'est
this particular document
de démontrer pourquoi
is,
un document particulier,
aside from being relevant, but why it should be relied upon by this trial chamber,
pourquoi la chambre
and why
devrait
at some point
le considérer.
It should have any
et pourquoi
weight
ce document
to this particular phase of the indictment that we're trying, that is trial number one, limited to that. And so we respectfully submit that we have provided our answers in our annex.
Nous avons They're general in nature, dans notre annexe.
But over the course of the last two or three days, we've amply noted why we believe
mais nous avons indiqué au cours des trois derniers jours pourquoi.
The prosecution cannot simply say, well, it's in the closing order, therefore it should be admitted.
Dire, ce document est présent
There's nothing
de clôture,
in international standards that says if something is in the indictment or if something is referenced in the indictment,
que si l'on fait référence à quoi que ce soit dans l'acte d'accusation,
was based on something that was shown to the judges as part of the process of determining whether sufficient evidence exists to indict. That in and of itself does not make that piece of evidence
le fait que des preuves
admissible.
Été montrées à la chambre pour
it merely means that it was used
assez d'indices pour lancer une poursuite ne signifie pas qu'il s'agit d'un élément de preuve recevable pour le procès.
Or the presiding judge who was involved in the indictment process
le
in factoring that as part of the test as to whether some evidence is sufficient to indict. That's all.
S'est penché sur ce document.
And therefore, for the prosecution to say, well, it's in the closing order, and therefore,
décider s'il fallait porter les accusations,
we submit that's not enough.
Mais quand
that's the first step. Now that we started the trial, they will have to lay
donc,
more of a foundation, and it's up to you to determine
donc, il est recevable,
whether
non, c'est la première
it should
étape.
Be admitted, and then whether it
il
should, how much weight, if any, to give
si
to
ce document
it.
Est recevable, Thank you. Et si on lui accorde quelques valeurs probantes que ce soit. Je vous remercie.
President, thank you, Defense Counsel.
We would now hand the floor to
Kusampon's defense.
Nous souhaitons maintenant laisser la parole à la défense de Kusampon.
Their objections to documents in A5 Annex.
Pour la présentation de ces exceptions aux documents de l'annexe 5.
Thank you, Mr. President. Good morning, Your Honor. Good morning, everyone.
Bonjour à tous.
Regarding Annex 5, that is the DK media and public statements
Annexe
put
5.
Forward by the prosecution.
Déclaration publique et de l'époque
and
du Cambodge démocratique,
documents
présenté par l'accusation, un total de 393 documents.
In document E158,
le document
E158, they attempt to give weight to the reliability in
écriture,
60
donc,
documents
il
of the 343 in this annex.
De 60 documents sur les 393 de cet annexe.
53 of those documents
53 de ces documents
were obtained by the Swedish collection.
Proviennent de la collection de documents suédois.
From FIBIS.
Ou du FBIS.
There are five of the remaining documents.
Cinq autres.
Which are the media report received from
Les rapports médiatiques qui proviennent du centre de documentation du Cambodge.
What we demand, as well as what we object to, regarding all the documents in this annex are the same as what we have already raised for the previous
nos objections
annexes.
Et nos demandes par rapport à cette annexe sont les mêmes que pour les autres annexes.
So I will not touch upon those grounds of objections in
Je
details.
Ne vais donc pas répéter en détail les motifs
Our
de
position
notre
is
objection.
The same. Let me give you an example, John.
Vous donner un exemple.
For the documents that they received as part of the Swedish collection,
les documents provenant de la collection suédoise,
they have only been received recently.
N'ont été reçus que récemment.
And the question we also ask is, have the Swedish government received those documents,
la suivante,
and
comment
from who?
Le gouvernement suédois a-t-il obtenu ces documents et de qui?
This is a one important question.
C'est une question très importante.
And it should have been explained to us
et
by the prosecution.
L'accusation aurait dû
as part
nous fournir cette explication.
Indicia of reliability of each document. So
comme
that
indice
we can
de fiabilité de ces documents
our debate before your chamber.
Pour qu'ils puissent être débattus devant la Chambre.
Once again, I still maintain our position, Mr. President.
Notre position, nous la maintenons. Je vous remercie, Monsieur le Président.
President, thank you, Defense Counsel.
Oui, je vous remercie, Maître.
As the prosecution has 1 hour to reply to these objections,
l'accusation dispose d'une heure pour
and
répondre
as the time
aux
is now appropriate for the break, the prosecution may take the floor
pause.
After we resume.
Nous vous
we will
la
now
sera l'accusation
have 20 minutes
au
break.
De la pause, vingtaine de minutes, 20 minutes, c'est-à-dire.
And we shall return at 20
to 11. Donc à 11h-20. Merci.